McNally, and it's doing this.
The highlighted route.
I'm sitting still. Almost 70,000 miles per hour I'm traveling. Come on, Ray McNally. This is the problem when you overlay your crap on Google Android. This is what you get. This is the problem. This is the kind of stuff I had the problem with the old one before it died on me.
To the highlighted route.
There's no reason for this. Zero. All the other GPSs you make, every other GPS unit you make that does not have the Google Android under it, doesn't do this. Only when you have the Google Android does it do this. This is unacceptable. You know, I like the size, I like the form factor, I like the way it functions when it works. But all that crap underneath of it, all that Google garbage, is a waste of time and money. If Rand McNally would make an Apple have it over top of an Apple underlayment, it wouldn't do that. But Rand McNally doesn't need to be doing anything with Google anyway. I swear, I don't get it sometimes. I wish that Rand McNally would partner with Apple to make an Apple tablet version of this. You know, I would buy that in a heartbeat. That way it's linked to all my other Apple gear, my phone, my watch, my tablet, my computer. I can update it better, faster. I can
to the highlighted route.
You know, that's ridiculous. Okay. 8:35. Finally got the call to go in and get loaded, so an hour late after, you know, my appointment time was. But that's not unexpected. So we're going to door 6. Apparently, at least that's what the young lady told me. We're going to back into this door. This wall in front of us on our right side. Well, we're picking up 2 coils at 47,000 pounds. Well, let me actually be able to hear. All right. So we're going to get backed in here, and then we're going to get ourselves loaded. Then we can pull out and get ourselves tarped. Alright. Get a little bit straighter there. frustrated as we can before we even get in the door. There we go, that's better. Got a little more room on our on the passenger side than we do on the driver's side. But we are between the lane, between the lines on the ground, so that's what we want. And of course, it's a dark hole. Bright sunshine outside, dark on the inside. Which makes it so much more safe. You know, when you're backing into that. Yeah, I can see a stop sign back there. I can see a yellow line, but just barely. of these big boys. So we're gonna get outside. We're gonna strap it down. We're gonna put on two felt blankets over for the edges. Give them more protection. And we're gonna put a tarp on it. And then, you know, tarp it down, make sure it's all nice tucked up underneath, and we're good to go. We got a little bit of weight on us, so we got to build up a little bit of air pressure. All right, here we go. Definitely heavy, definitely heavy. Back over to the tarping station. Get our blankets, get our straps, get our blankets on, throw our tarp, get that underneath down nice and tight, nice and smooth. Go back down to the loves where we were this morning. Get our scale ticket, make sure we're set to go. Sure to split our axles. Because then, you know, driving with them together while you're empty or on a real light load is just fine. But with a heavy load like this, like I said, 47,000 pounds of aluminum coiled sheets. That's a little heavy, so we'll make sure to split that axle, spread that weight out as much as we can. Now, 47,300 pounds is the absolute heaviest load I've ever carried. Now, 46 I've been at, but this is officially the heaviest load I've ever carried. Done was angled these docks here, these tarping stations. That'd have been a whole lot easier to get out of or into, I mean, with a heavy load.
Then pull out the plug. I'm in a bad spot here. Yeah, I mean, you know, first thing, you know, they sent me to the wrong gate. They have a weekend, a gate to go through on the weekend. You know, which is kind of stupid. You know, why not keep the same gate, you know, for everything, no matter what time of day or night? Well, okay, you know, the gate for, you know, the normal part of the week, a long entrance way, long driveway to get into, so you're not blocking public traffic. You know, and there's plenty of parking on the side of that road. Then once you get in, there's a big ass parking lot for all the trucks to sit and wait. You know, at least 40 or 50 trucks minimum. And, you know, so, but, you know, so now I have to go back out to the main road through a little gate that has barely enough room for a semi to fit in, and only two trucks can actually fit on that little bit of driveway before you get to the gate, so trucks are going to back up on the road. And then, you know, once you do all your little safety signing crap, you know, yeah, which I didn't even watch. you know, this is coming from the people in the office. All the sounds
got in. They got into the door right away. I had to wait an hour. Yeah, so that's always a treat. So, yeah, that's always fun. So, you know, now let's get this stuff, get my straps on, get my tarp on, and we'll be good to go, you know. So, you know, one, the guy who's in the building who came out, you know, The little office was about 100 feet away. He had to get on a little cart to come over to see me. He just couldn't walk over. He
He just couldn't walk over. He had to use a little golf cart. No.
Yeah, I didn't know where he was. They're still laying up there on the shipping counter.
So the guy inside said, you know, give me instructions. Come out, tarp strap, come get your paperwork. So, you know, I follow the instructions I'm given. You know. I mean, it doesn't matter either way, still get it before I leave anyway, so.
So it's a little bit longer than what a what my mid tarp will do. So you know, just throw the, I'm not gonna try to roll up a tarp. I'm just gonna throw the another tarp on top of it. A little extra protection, nobody everybody wins, except for me, but you know, I get a little bit of extra workout, so it's really not that bad. So now we just gotta bungee it up and, like I said, head down to the Loves for a scale ticket, you know, just to make double extra super duper sure that, you know, I'm good to go down the road, you know. And I wish they had a scale here. I didn't see one. I was given no instructions for one. But we got a split tandem. We got a split axle split. We're loaded right on the center line. So one in front, one right in back of the center line. And we're even left to right. I got four straps for each coil. Crisscross from the front and from the back. So a crisscross at 45 degrees. Then I got two in the middle with a small X, you know, right at each one of these right here. So one here, crisscrossing. So the one in the front goes to the back, one in the back goes to the front. So we're good. Like I said, we just got to bungee up and then we'll be on our way. Get our scale ticket. Then we're gonna skedaddle down the road. And we'll do our macros when we get, once we get over to the Loves. Screw it. First way.
Second
12086. Split axle.
Did you say a split axle?
Yes, please.
Hold on one second. Okay, truck number?
12086. Yes, sir. Back to where, sir?
You want to move to the next axle, position two.
Alright. So you want my splits on number one and number two?
I got number one and number two.
Alright, pulling forward. Okay. Pulling forward.
No. So you gotta move to the next axle.
Yeah, so you want the splits on number one and number two, correct?
Yeah, I've got splits on one and two. I just gotta do three so we can complete it.
Alright, where do you want my trailer axle then?
So you have to move that one spot.
Alright, move backwards, one spot, okay. All right. All right, thank you. See, that's the problem with, you know, some of the training that goes on, because in the past I've done split axle, you know, weights on the cat scales, and they've told me to pull forward to plate number one and plate number two. This guy wanted me to move backwards. You know, it needs to be uniform. It just needs to be uniform. Alright. Let's get ourselves in a parking spot here. So we're out of everybody's way. Alright, nobody behind us.
catch. And a bump on the curb and you're stuck.